Hey guys, welcome back to the Friday Vlog, where we discuss activity that goes on here with the BuzzWeaver channel. That includes things like current events, headlines that are in the news, social media technology, and items of interest that come up during the week that allow us to have a little bit of a dialogue. I would encourage you guys now to give me a follow there on BitChute if you have not already, or even consider joining BitChute. It is an alternative video hosting site, very similar to YouTube, which you guys can find similar material on there as well. But nonetheless, I do want to thank all you guys who have joined me and are following me there on BitChute, and of course, those who are on the additional alternative media sites where you see this video. I want to thank all you guys. If you are here for the very first time or a frequent visitor, I would encourage you now for YouTubers to click on that watermark down there in the bottom right-hand corner, and for the alternative viewers to give me a follow on those platforms. In gaming news this week, we have the release of Call of Duty Modern Warfare. You can see my channel introduction right up here in the top right-hand corner. For both PC and PlayStation 4, the game will release on Thursday, October the 24th at 6 p.m. Pacific time and or 9 p.m. Eastern time here on the East Coast, and I am looking very much forward to playing it. We don't have any times, or I have not seen any time for Xbox, but nonetheless, the release will be in full form on Friday for all those around the world. But nonetheless, I am looking very much forward to it, so you can anticipate seeing some of that coverage here on the channel. Not too long ago, the EU was going to introduce measures that were going to create a bit of a problem for both UK and European YouTube content creators. And that was that they wanted these creators to get a release or some sort of permission to be able to utilize content out of the UK and or Europe. That includes articles, that includes video, anything pertaining to media that would be coming out of the UK or Europe. A content creator would have to get permission from the creator, from the journalist, from the writers, from the producers, from whomever was necessary to be able to use their content. And that measure never seemed to come to fruition and never seemed to pass. However, in a recent story, as I will read to you, hundreds of journalists called Wednesday for European officials to take action against Google over its refusal to pay media companies for displaying their content in defiance of a strict new EU copyright law. Now, that particular copyright law does not apply to content creators. This apparently is directed at Google itself. But Google said last month that articles, pictures, videos would be shown in search results only if media firms consent to let the tech giant use it for free. Now you gotta remember, Google is the largest search engine on the internet. So they aren't charging these journalists and others for any type of advertisement when people are conducting a search, right? I mean, it's free, you're doing a search. There's not a targeted, for example, there isn't a targeted campaign for these particular journalists or media. So Google has countered that it benefits news publishers by sending more than 8 billion visits to their websites each month in Europe alone. So there you have it. On a search, if your articles or if your media or other topics come up in a search, people can go to it. You know, you didn't have to pay for that search algorithm, that SEO that you were, you know, suggesting that you want to argue about. We don't pay for links to be included in search results because it would undermine the trust of users, right? So in other words, if there were some sort of fee that you would pay, right? There are people who pay for advertisements and other things to get a higher ranking on Google. For example, remember we recently heard about Tulsi Gabbard paying for advertisement when she was the most searched name, and how Google was holding back on her advertisement and so forth because supposedly they were checking her payment processors and this, that, and the other, which was really just a stall tactic in reality, as we've come to learn now. As a matter of fact, right now she is pursuing YouTube for having suppressed her again during the exchange that she had with Hillary Clinton. That was a topic I was gonna go into, but I changed my mind. So in other words, Google's vice president in charge of news said in Paris last month that, of course, It would undermine the trust of the users if for some reason, you know, suddenly you start paying to be able to appear in certain search results. But nonetheless, here we have the EU trying to push back, and we're going to go into a topic in the next segment that's really going to kind of solidify a lot of this perhaps, or bring a lot of this type of activity into focus. We have a bit of a European theme going on this week in the Friday Vlog, but it is very important and it is very critical because, of course, we are nearing Brexit, at least in the UK and Europe for all my friends there. We are getting very close. Now, I enjoyed learning about this and keeping up with this information, so it isn't like it's a big mystery. There was a lot of talk, there was a lot of commentary, there was a lot of coverage. I watched several documentaries on the topic. As a matter of fact, if you look down in the published section, I will give you a link to one of those documentaries that outlines Brexit in a very comprehensive way, because you guys know I try to take the complicated and the difficult and make it very simple, because typically it is very simple, but of course in the hands of journalism, in the hands of politicians, it can become murky and very distracting because they're trying to inject their own particular narratives. Now, for those who may not be familiar, I'm going to give you guys a quick outline here. Brexit is the scheduled withdrawal of the United Kingdom from the European Union following a June 2016 referendum in which 51.9% voted to leave. 51.9% voted to leave. The UK government formally announced the country's withdrawal in March 2017. Formally announced it, starting a two-year process that was due to conclude with the UK withdrawing on March the 29th, 2019. We know that didn't happen. As a matter of fact, when the measure was, or when the referendum was passed, David Cameron, the current Prime Minister at the time, resigned. He was a Remainer. And then, of course, Theresa May took over, who herself was also a Remainer. And we saw the debacle that happened after it. And, of course, now we have Boris Johnson there, who would, it does appear that he's just going to go with a straight no deal at all. And, I mean, from an American perspective, you have to understand from our perspective, or I can only give you my opinion in particular, but from our perspective, this really returns the sovereignty back to the United Kingdom. I mean, I understand what the EU was offering, I understand the processes and minutiae and all the details to it, but just from an American perspective, I would much rather see the United Kingdom, now again, this is my opinion, I would much rather see the United Kingdom be a sovereign nation unto itself as opposed to being a vassal of the EU. That's a bit hyperbolic, but that's just kind of the way I see it, right? I mean, the EU is like a country club that offers you some really great deals, but at the expense of your laws, at the expense of your country, at the expense of your people, and it's just not worth it. The value in return is not worth being part of the EU. Now, my prediction is going to be that both the EU and the Remainers are probably going to make it as difficult and as miserable as possible, just like we see here with all of the Trump detractors in the mainstream media, who, by the way, are a minority voice in our country, because it looks like they're going full partisan as we lead up to the 2020 election and so forth. I think they're going to go full partisan on the Democrats, because they don't have a candidate that can win, and so all they can do is paint a dark cloud over the president and just try to be, unfortunately, very negative as they have been for the last 3.5 years. But nonetheless, guys, back to Brexit. So I think that perhaps the EU and probably Remainers will try to make things very difficult. It's going to be a very unpleasant time, perhaps, in the UK, because they're going to have to basically rebuild their finances, their economics, who they do trade with, all these types of very unique components to a country are going to come into effect. Now, of course, the UK, of course, can now reach out to the United States, to Canada, to China, to Russia, to Brazil, South America, all these other countries that have been wanting to do direct business with the United Kingdom for quite some time. And of course, we're not gonna have all of the particular markups and all the other types of problems based upon the one market system that the EU has. But nonetheless, I get a feeling that unfortunately, it's gonna be a very difficult time on purpose by some people in the UK to make it as difficult as possible. So people will, I guess, clamor for or try to call for another referendum to be able to get back into the EU. So it's going to be a very interesting time. I always liken this situation to a divorce, right? So you have one spouse that just has this level of angst and irritation because, you know, their golden goose and their money train is now not wanting to be the producer. And I'm not picking one or the other side when it comes to divorce. I'm just kind of giving you guys a brief analogy. But nonetheless, I will be keeping up with all the activity up until that point. But if you guys want to see that documentary, it's very well done, explains it very well. It will be down in the published section below. And that's gonna wrap it up for this Friday vlog. I would encourage you guys now to click that like button down there in the bottom right-hand corner, as it does help support the video, as well as the obligatory channel icon appearing right there on the screen to subscribe, along with that notification if you would like to. And of course, follow me there on BitChute. And I will see you guys right there behind the camera next week.